Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. We have with us today a very special guest. We have the political editor of NDTV with us here today, Mr. Rahul Srivastava. Welcome, sir. So, how did a young boy from a small town make it big into the world of broadcast journalism?
You see, I come from a family of traditional army men.
All right.
And I was editing my school magazine. I was editing my college magazine.
All right.
And since everybody in my family was part of a very structured, disciplined life, I decided that somebody has to get indisciplined and live a life which has absolutely no discipline. There's nothing called time, there's nothing called deadline.
Absolutely.
So I ventured. I perhaps, my temperament, I did not think about it that much, but perhaps it suited me. I thought it will suit me. It has suited me that I survived in it for 28 years.
28 years, that's a long time.
Yes, that's long
okay. Time. So what is the worst experience you've had as a broadcast journalist so far?
You see, the worst experience of a journalist are the days when he does not have a story.
Right.
The best experience are the days when he has to struggle and he still has a story.
All right.
There is nothing more frustrating than a few things that the story that you wanted or you had does not get confirmed. These are bad days. The story which you thought was there does not turn out to be correct. Usually you will find that once you spend a certain amount of time having a story, getting it confirmed, mm-hmm. and doing exactly what you're supposed to do in the profession is eventually the most delightful thing.
Right.
You may get beaten up, it may get bad, it may get ugly. I've been beaten up, I've got 17 stitches on my head,
Governments
have come down, bones have been broken. But those are good experiences. Eventually, this is a journalistic exercise.
Right.
Because a lot of people say a lot of things about journalism. Eventually, we feel journalism is always finding out something that somebody is trying to hide.
Right.
Rest is advertising. So in that process, if you get something, you get beaten up, you get tired, you don't get food. Those are hardships which even a soldier has to go through.
That's like a part
which
of
a lot of
the
people
process.
Have to, a daily wage laborer does it.
Right.
But the fact is that eventually at the end of the day, your job is to tell a story. Maybe somebody is trying to hide or somebody wants to show. That job, once it gets full, it's not. So the bad days are the days when you don't have a story or you don't really get around to finish that story.
Okay, sir. And what is that one story which has made your career? The best story of your entire career?
None.
None?
I don't think career does not hinge on a story. I think usually journalists should remember that it is a perseverance that how you are, there is a famous Sylvester Stallone movie in which there is a dialogue that it is not how hard I hit somebody that decides my life.
It's how hard you can get hit.
How hard you get hit and still keep going on. Eventually, the perseverance with which you can sustain. You may do a story today, it may not even go on air.
Right.
You may do a story, it may not have any space, it may get done by somebody else tomorrow, it will never go
right.
on air. The point is, you put it behind you, next day you're back at the drawing board trying to find out a story. That's what makes a journalist.
Right.
How responsible you have been, I say that perhaps what has made me, what people perhaps talk about, is that my story has never gone wrong, not one in 28 years. Perhaps that's what
wonderful.
Makes us wrong.
That's wonderful.
So, I have interviewed the sitting president of India, which is nobody in this country has ever done. I have been beaten up, chief minister had to resign because of my stories, ministers have resigned in the central government. Those are part of a daily job. I think what makes a career is very hard work. There is no glamour in this job.
Okay.
It's really hard sweat. We have right now Kashmir crisis going on,
right.
in which my reporter has been there for the last 3-4 days. His family is missing.
Oh my goodness.
Without emotions, without tears, he's reporting about people who are missing. Maintaining that objectivity. That's what makes a career.
That's the spirit of the business.
That's the business.
All right. So, any advice for people who are aspiring to become a journalist like yourself?
Read. You will find that at times when you talk about, say, today you have a lot of newer stars in television.
Right.
Or say what you can call the role models. Say a Barkha Dutt.
Hmm.
I have spent my time and I have seen organizations. I joined NDTV some 15, 16 years ago, but before that I have been in 12 organizations. This is my 13th job. I have not seen somebody as dedicated as her.
All right.
She's literally bordering around as if she's got some energy dynamo moving inside her. When she's out in the field, the amount of studying she does, the amount of phoning she does, the amount of finding out of information does, it's tremendous work.
So the hard work never ceases.
It's not a matter of ceasing. It's a matter that hard work is the bedrock. You have to read. The public is, at one time, 20 years ago, the public was did not know about, say, WTO, GATT, and all these things. Today, you have got very intelligent young people like you, for example, watching news. Now, the moment they realize that I am not well-versed with the subject and I'm just gassing on air, you will catch see through, and then you will I will lose that airtime equity which I hold.
Absolutely. Moreover, your credibility.
Yes, credibility comes from accuracy. Credibility comes from accuracy. Never speak too much.
All right.
Brevity. You say the right word in the right manner. These are the basic ethics on journalism which will never change. I have seen the people who speak more, they make more mistakes. Those who are more keen to go on air and have less substance, they make mistakes.
Absolutely.
And these are the issues because the it's not that the medium has really changed, it's because the public has changed. The viewing public,
whatever you may say,
there are newer channels have come. But today, say somebody like Dr. Pranoy Roy and NDTV have still a very dedicated old viewership because they believe that we represent some values.
Absolutely.
And you earn a reputation in decades and it can get destroyed in half an hour. At times when you're breaking a story, you might have 30 seconds to think about it. Say you're reporting a story between a friction between the judiciary and the parliament and the MPs and the government. There are at least 100 laws in which you can get penalized for contempt. You may hurt somebody. So all those laws and all those sensitivities have to run through your mind, and you have to know them, read them, laws, bylaws, state laws, international laws, precedences, past happenings, dates.
When
you're talking about something, you have to if you remember dates and you give dates, accurate dates with happenings, people say, my God, this person remembers what happened 50 years ago.
Right.
Who said what 50 years ago? That is why reading, hard work, and I think diligence and dedication are irreplaceable.
Okay, and what about people looking to get into your field? You are a political editor. People wanting to specialize in political journalism?
I think there is a crisis happening in today's this thing that I come from an old school where I believe that having studied a subject before doing journalism is much more important. Nowadays, people are studying journalism as a graduation course.
Right.
I always believe that a subject empowers a person, any subject you may study. I think there is a bit about political journalism. There is a bit of an instinct involved in it. You have to be a bit of a political animal for it. How you understand human character, how you understand, because politics is not just politics between netas or elections.
Right.
Politics is when you're talking to me, our interaction has certain amount of political component. So during while I'm talking to you, I'm actually trying to understand what you are.
Absolutely.
And in that, the predictability or the unpredictability eventually is the politics. And that is why I think you should have an instinct for it. Don't opt for something which you don't think you are good at. Don't. I think that's one big mistake people make, because by the time the first 2-3 years are gone, they eventually burn out because they expected something to happen, but their instinct and heart was not trained to it, and they falter.
Okay. Well, that was Mr. Rahul Srivastava, political editor of NDTV. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Mr. Shirali Chandra signing off.